Yes, a very welcome to this new episode of Off to the 7000 Island. And as promised, I make another part two of this video as we traveled. And I just wanted to reflect a little bit on how we felt and how things are going. Because, you know, when you have this sort of change, big change in your life, you have this sort of sentimental phase when you need to say goodbye and all this, and then you have this really exciting phase where you look forward to, and those come pretty much together. But because we had so much stress, actually we didn't have much of that sort of we're saying goodbye and that's really now the finish. We had that mostly when we left our house in Tübingen, and when we sort of said goodbye to all the friends, and of course we said goodbye to all the family in Dresden as well. And that was difficult, but we still had lots of stress working out everything and watching if all the regulations stay the same, or do we need to bring something else, and do we have everything. And that sort of stopped us from being like sort of sad about leaving, because we just had adrenaline in our bodies and were going and quite busy with everything, and then, you know, packing bags and all this kind of stuff. And then we thought, okay, well, we can actually let ourselves be sentimental when we checked in at the airport, because we have like 3 hours time before we need to be at the airplane, and we still have some time to say goodbye properly to my parents as well, and also just to say goodbye in a sense to Germany and how everything went. And well, that didn't happen because we were stressed again about those flights which were not possible to get. And if you haven't seen the video previously, I can link it up here and in the description down below. You can have a look how we went on our journey. But yes, that was the kind of thing we had, and that was kind of I think a missed opportunity as well that might be coming after us, because I think we didn't say properly goodbye. We didn't really finish that because we were like trying to get on that airplane. And I think closing one chapter properly, I think would have been quite important, and so it's a bit hanging. And then we've been in the quarantine hotel, which is kind of, you hang like in the middle. And then we came last night, we arrived here in Manila, and I think it really hit us like, oh, now we're really here. Now we really need to work things out, how it's gonna be here, and this big step in our lives gonna start. And also thinking a bit like, in Corona times, we're gonna go into the hotel business. Are we actually sane or insane? And yeah, so we've been thinking all this, and I think there's lots of excitement right now. We are quite excited to go, and when we're finally there, then Christmas time is happening and everything, so that's nice. But I think yesterday it sort of hit us in a way. And yeah, it really helped us that you are thinking about that, that you're praying for us. And I want to actually show you something really cool what the church in Tübingen made for us, or the student group in Tübingen made for us, which is quite cool. They made us a little tea set, so that's a tea box with little different teas. And in those, they made us a little sets for each, for each day in quarantine. There's two tea bags for each day. There's one, and there's on one side there's a little number, and on the other side there's a Bible verse. And that was really, really cool, or is really cool, because in quarantine you don't have so much to do and you cannot do so much. You know, the internet is bad and you're tired, exhausted from the flight, jet lag, everything, and all this. So that was really cool. We've been drinking a lot of tea, just to pass some time and to not stuff us just with chocolate. And I think on the second day we were reading a number 3, actually, and that's quite cool. It's a verse from Jesaja, and I just paraphrase it because it's in German, and it's about that God's thoughts are higher than our own and his ways are bigger than our ways. And that really comforts us and helps us to think more like, okay, we don't understand everything what's going on right now and why things are not going according to plan, but we know there's a God who is all-knowing and all in control, and he doesn't let anything happen just for no reason, but there's always a reason. There's no chance. We don't believe in chance. And so this has encouraged us. We also did read a lot in Mark's gospel, and now in a few days it's the 1st of December, so we will start with a Christmas devotion, an Advent devotion in the book of Ruth, which hopefully is quite cool. There's always a little text and then some thoughts to it and some questions, and we're gonna do that together. And that hopefully will help us as well, just to be focused on God, because I think now with having all this, Alyssa needs to start working soon. I need to start learning the language, and now we can't push it away. We are actually here. We need to start. In Germany it was easier because you can say, oh yeah, well, when I'm there I learned the language, and now we're here and I got to learn the language. Yeah, that's those things, and thank you that you're on that journey. And if you made it so far, why not give that video a thumbs up? And if you're not subscribed and you like our content, which is a bit wild and all over the place, but if you like it, then please subscribe to our channel to stay up to date with all our videos. And we have planned for Advent some Christmas episodes we filmed basically already in Germany, and just want to share a little bit about how Christmas is in Germany for us is important in Germany for Christmas as well. Just some little glimpse of it, and then probably about the Philippines as well. And we will keep you always up to date as soon as we can. And thank you for being with us, and thank you for watching.